Most of our old stone walls in New England were built when this country was very young. Some might be quite a bit older.
I cannot prove what I'm saying, but I believe this is a pre-colonial stone wall.
Mike Trudeau of the Burlington Historical Commission has joined us at the Francis Wyman House, a historic home in private hands since 1666. But what's brought us here is a very unusual hole in the wall.
The opening aligns with the sunrise of the winter solstice.
No one has ever been able to pinpoint a purpose for this mysterious stone chamber, says Trudeau, but he says it's hard to imagine a colonial subsistence farmer building it.
What busy farmer would spend all this time to put together a chamber capped by a stone weighing between 1 and 2 tons where you can't do anything with it?
There are actually hundreds of stone chambers throughout New England, most notably at America's Stonehenge in Salem, New Hampshire. Trudeau's best guess is that this curious hole in the wall served some sort of ceremonial purpose for Native Americans.
Officially speaking, for the Francis Wyman Association, I can tell you that your guess is as good as mine, but that is my guess.
The primal power of stone. Not just for masons anymore.
I think of it as a paintbrush. You know, their fingers are like a paintbrush, and then somehow magically it happens.
Stonework play, a form of creative learning and expression. Diana Suskind, a former professor of education at Fitchburg State, came up with the idea while working with kids in Nepal, where supplies were scarce. She soon realized there were no limits to its appeal.
These children were poor, but I've done it with wealthy children. I've done it at museums. I've done it like all over, and no matter who does it, like I never played with stones before, or I didn't know they have such power.
Participants select their stones, make designs, then share stories with the group to go along with their creations.
The process was emotional. We're all different colors, different sizes, different strengths, different designs.
Diane Tousignant intended to make a flower, but ends up with 3 spirals she calls We Are One.
It almost felt like the stones have energy. So it was beautiful, a beautiful experience. I would encourage everybody to play.
Even trained scientists are not immune to the power of stone.
Why do people put one stone on top of another? I think they're just programmed to do it. Think about the use of stone in our society. It's really, really important, and not just for utilitarian reasons. It's cosmic.
Geologist and author Robert Thorson is pleased that the New England stone wall is coming out of the shadows, as it were, and experiencing its moment in the sun.
They're literally artifacts that we would otherwise treasure in museums, but they're too big for museums. I argue that they're the Stone Age of New England that resulted from that agricultural civilization that created the place that we've all come to love.
And Stonewall fans, you're a fan.
I love them. I think they're absolutely beautiful. They look like a piece of artwork, as you just said. Mm-hmm. That is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Shayna Seymour.
And I'm Anthony Everett. Have a great weekend. Hope to see you back here on Monday night.